These issues around safe chemicals and sustainability are very important to Kaiser Permanente because our mission is to improve the health of the communities that we serve. Manufacturers of products that are inherently safe and manufacturers that have been striving to use safer chemicals are very happy to tell us what's in their products. We discovered that our carpet contained PVC backing, and PVC contributes to dioxin pollution. So that was an awakening for us to understand what was in the product and to have that disclosed by the manufacturers. Next, in assessing and avoiding hazards, we had to look at what might be available on the market to be an alternative to PVC. And in looking for it, we couldn't find carpet that was PVC free that was appropriate for healthcare. It didn't exist. So we went to our manufacturers and we told them the dilemma. And we ended up contracting with two manufacturers and said, it's a 2-year contract, and within those 2 years, you need to develop a PVC free carpet that meets all of our performance and quality standards and doesn't cost any more than what we're paying today. One of the manufacturers was able to do that. And we were able to then provide them with a sole source contract for PVC-free carpet. And a couple of other kind of nice attributes about the carpet: the backing is made out of a product that comes from windshield glass that was being discarded. So we're actually taking something out of the landfill and using it for a productive purpose. And the carpet that we use also gets recycled. We were able, through our own efforts and our own contract, to create demand for a product, and that product is now available not just to the healthcare sector, but also to schools, any commercial facility that wants to have PVC-free carpet. And then ultimately, because it has become more and more of a standard, I think that as we look at sustainable architecture and other sorts of practices within the healthcare sector, for sure, that PVC-free carpet is becoming a standard. So we've really seen from several years ago, first looking at what the hazard is and understanding it, to really today having something that's widely available and acknowledged as being a best practice. Well, a good example of industry standards are what's been going on in healthcare architecture over the last 5 to 10 years. And Kaiser Permanente has been very much engaged in that process. And that's resulted in the Green Guide for Healthcare, which is a publication, it's a checklist, and many healthcare organizations are now using that as the standard for how to create sustainable, healthy healthcare buildings. 10 years ago, mercury was ubiquitous in healthcare, and today at Kaiser Permanente, we actually are virtually mercury-free. And that's a great example of using supplier disclosure information to say, do your products have mercury? And if the answer was yes, then we'd say, can you give us something without mercury? And can you give it to us at the same cost and the same quality with the same performance standards? And so by making those product selections, we were able to help drive mercury out of our systems. So a number of years ago, as we were attempting to reduce the amount of PVC in our facilities, we realized that some devices that have PVC also have a hazardous ingredient called phthalate, DEHP, and it was especially problematic in neonatal units. So we went about a process where, first of all, we had to identify which products might even have DEHP in them, because products are not labeled to contain that information. So we didn't know for sure, but we made an educated guess. And then we went on the market to look for alternatives to those products. And in some cases we were successful and in others not. And where we were successful, we traded out those products. And where we weren't successful, we worked with manufacturers to develop safe alternatives to products that contain DEHP. And today we have changed out all of our products for which there is a safe alternative in our neonatal units. There are many factors in making a product selection. One of them is obviously to drive the market to get the safe alternatives, but we also want to use expert contracting and negotiations to be able to ensure that our health plan is affordable. A great example we have of assessing and avoiding hazards is a project we work on with what are called PCA pumps. These are patient-controlled analgesic pumps, and it's a little device that a patient presses on a button and they get pain medication released. And the devices that we were using contain PVC. But that's when our supply chain and procurement staff kicked into high gear to negotiate a contract that ended up allowing us to get the product that was PVC free, and it actually cost less than the current contract that we were holding. And so it's a great demonstration of saying assessing and avoiding hazards is part of it. And the other part of it about being realistic in business is that we have to negotiate it in terms that make sense for us as an organization. And by using really expert supply chain staff and techniques, we were able to achieve both of those goals with that one product.